Well, that was crazy.
What was your first reaction after you had read the screenplay?
So I actually didn't read the screenplay before. Director Stoner called me quite abruptly one day when I was eating dinner, and he said, oh, I'm shooting something next month, will be in it? And I said, okay, sure. And so I was quite surprised when I read the screenplay. And also, he also asked me, there's going to be a kiss scene, is that okay? And I said, yeah, sure. And I expected something romantic, but it wasn't quite so romantic.
Did you get a lot of practice for kiss scene? You want a description?
Of course.
So how was the process of working with Director Sana? Did you learn a lot from him, or you know, how much freedom did he give you to develop your character?
もらうことができて、ものすごく、多分、ステップアップができたと思うんですけど、なので、だからこそ、話よりも、ものすごく信頼している監督ですし、ものすごく熱い監督ですので、一緒にやってあげたので、やりたいと思って、今回もさせていただいたんですけど、これはどちらかというと、秘密が割と、厳しく教えていただいたんですけど、
厳しく指導していただいたんですけど、なんか、とにかく自由に、映画を見て、それをリスペクトしてっていう中で、あんなカリーナのようにとか、すごいこう、いろいろ、ページだけオレンジのようにみたいな感じのことが、本当にいろいろあって、そういう面白さもありましたね。でも、監督は、打ち上げの時に、
So
before this film, Director Sono and I worked on Himizu, and in the process of making Himizu, he really allowed me to break free as an actor, and I was able to take a huge leap because of him. And so, of course, we had this level of trust, so that's why I was able to go on this film without even having to read the screenplay. And, of course, he's a man with so much fire and passion, so of course, I wanted to be on set with him. And also, while we were shooting Himizu, he was quite severe and strict at times. This time, he allowed me to be completely free.
And, of course, as you saw in the film, there's a mention of God of Cinema, and also he made a lot of references to Anna Karenina, Clockwork Orange, and so on. So it was very interesting for me to see him work. And at the wrap party, though, Director Sono said, I was quite stressed out while we were shooting this film because this was one of the first times that I allowed my actors to be so free.
Mm-hmm. So which is your favorite Sono film and why?
そうですね。まあ、のりこの食卓が私は個人的にはすごく好きなんですけど、今回はまた新しいそのさんの代表作ができたんじゃないかなと思うので、それと同じぐらい、まあ、これは大好きですね。
My personal favorite is Noriko's Table, Dining Table, but I think this film is just as representative of what Director Sono can do, so I like it just as much.
You know, before shooting this film, were you familiar with the Yakuza genre films and the tradition of Yakuza cinema? So, like Ningyo Eiga and...
まあ日本はVシネって言ってすごいヤクザ映画がいっぱいありますので、まあそういうのがうちの母がすごく映画が好きで、そういうのも小さい頃に見たりして、すごく人が殺される シーンとかうちの母はよく私にこう目隠しをしてたんですけど、まあでも全然そういうふうに一つ日本の映画カルチャーの中の一つのVシネっていう分野がありますので、そういうのは認識してましたし、でもその薬剤映画にとどまらない、これは映画になったと思うので、すごい良かったと思います。
Well, in Japanese cinema, there's a tradition of V cinema, the Yakuza cinema, and my mother was a huge cinephile. She loved films, and even as a young girl, I watched quite a lot of films with her, and she would often cover my eyes during the scenes where somebody dies and so on, but I was aware of the culture of V cinema as a genre. But the great thing about this movie in particular is that it just doesn't restrict itself to that particular Yakuza genre.
So, for all of its craziness, this film is very Japanese. Do you see yourself starring in foreign films? You know, do you have that kind of ambition and interest?
Yes, of course. I'm very curious, interested.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Mm.
Are there any foreign directors you would like to work with? Or?
ニューヨークだったらイラン人の映画監督のアミールとやりたいですし、そういっぱいいるんです。フランスの映画も好きなので、レオス・カラックスもすごく大好きだし、本当にいっぱいいます。韓国映画だってやりたいし。
Well, there are quite a number of filmmakers I would love to work with, but well, if I were to speak of a New York City-based filmmakers, I would say Amir Naderi. He's the Iranian filmmaker, and I'm also interested in French films, so maybe Léos Carax, and of course, I'm also interested in Korean films as well.
Well, which are some of your favorite films that you've seen recently, or?
今年本当に忙しくて、なかなかこう映画館に行く時間がないんですけど、大阪でこの間撮影をしてて、グランドブダペストホテルを見に行って、もうウェス・アンダーソン本当に結婚してほしいって思うぐらいものすごいもう大好きで、本当に今回もすっごく面白くて、でもああいう世界観に私はアジア人として出れるのかな、どうなのかなっていうすごい感慨深いところもあったんですけど、最高だったなと思います。
So this past year, I've been so busy that I've hardly had any time to go to the movies. But while I was shooting in Osaka a few days before, I saw the Wes Anderson's Grand Budapest Hotel, and just Wes Anderson, he's just phenomenal. I want him to marry me, really. But I also wonder, though, if as an Asian actress, I would be able to find myself in that world that he creates. I'm very interested.
So what does cinema mean to you? Are films important? Why?
映画とは、とっても難しい質問ですね。
What a difficult question.
何でしょう。面白いこと言った方がいいのか、真剣なこと言った方がいいのか。
I wonder if you're expecting a funny response or a serious response from me.
Maybe both.
そうですね。まあ、私にとっては、まあ、生きがいですし、なくてはならないもの、空気と同じぐらい大切なものだと思ってます。
For me, I can't live without it. It's like air. It's like.
Let's start taking questions from the audience. A mic will be passed around, so you know, wait until you receive the mic before you ask the question. So let's see. Questions from the audience. Yes, sir, gentleman over there. Could you raise? Yeah, just raise your hand.
Prior to this film, did you have any previous experience in swordplay in the movie?
一度もなかったですね。
No, not even once. This was first time.
まあ、何回か練習はしたんですけど、あの時はとにかくもう気分はもうハイパーだったので、もう気分に身を任せて、気分と映画のあの撮影現場の空気に。それでやっぱ国村さんであったり堤さんがものすごくもう縦指導を一緒にしてくださったので、練習をしながら、あとアクションももうその場でやってみるっていうことを常にやってました。
So it was my first time, but I did practice quite a while, of course. But while we were shooting, I was feeling quite hyper, and I just allowed my emotions to take me where it may. And I was also just allowed myself to be inspired by the atmosphere of the set. And also the actors, Mr. Kunimura and Mr. Tsutsumi, were very generous in teaching me and instructing me on set. So it just all occurred naturally on set.
Yeah. Great job.
Thank you.
Next question. Over there? Yep, you. Yes. Just wait for the mic.
So there are a lot of ridiculous scenes in the movie, obviously. How were you able, like, did you break character often? Like, I don't know how you were able to keep a straight face during some of these scenes, especially the one where you're chewing on glass kissing, or when you kiss Koji at the end and he's missing a hand and it's up on the ceiling holding on to a sword.
まあ、カメラが回ってないところではもうゲラゲラ笑ってましたし、でもコージが死ぬところは映画ができたらすごく面白くなってる気が面白くなってるんですけれども、現場はものすごくシリアスで、ものすごく愛のあるものすごくこうロマンチックなはずだったのに、映画が完成したら全部ギャグになってたからちょっとびっくりしました。
So, Well, the camera wasn't rolling. I was actually in stitches. It was very, very funny to shoot. But at the same time, it was a very serious set. And with the romantic scene, the intention for myself and my co-star was to shoot a romantic scene. We had expected it to be romantic in the end, but we saw the final product, and it was much of a gag. So I was quite surprised.
Thanks. Yeah. Third row, gentleman in white shirt. Just keep your hand raised, yes. Thank you.
I noticed during the last scene when you're doing the run-up to do the sword play that you had to do like small steps. How many times did you slip in the blood in all of those final scenes where everything was just coated in totality?
あれはアクションシーンの指導の方が結構即興でここでスライディングしちゃおうって決めてやって、で練習も何もしてなかったし、でもやっぱりほら気分はハイパーじゃないですか。だからとりあえずやってみますって言ったらできたんで、そんなにテイクは重ねなかったですね。ただやっぱりカット終わらなきゃいけないので何カットか やりましたけど、もう時の爽快感は忘れられません。
So that action scene, the choreographer of the action scene, he sort of improvised that scene. So he just asked me to do it. And of course, I was feeling quite hyper. So it was just one of those instances where I did it and I was able to do it. And of course, they needed different shots. So I did a few takes, of course. But I could never forget that sense of exhilaration that I felt.
Question? Yes, in the back. Yes. Just wait for the mic.
Yes. Obviously, tonight we had two movies about the Yakuza, both obviously very funny. And just wondering if there's ever been, if it's okay now to make fun of the Yakuza in Japanese cinema. Is there any type of, repercussion, or, I mean, do they mind they're made fun of to the extent that they have been? Because I know in the past, I know Juzo Itami, that's a very different situation, obviously. But just don't mean to bring that up, but just wondering if there's any type of...
そうですね。まあ多分そのさんは殺されてないんで全然大丈夫だと思うんですけど。
Well, director Sono is still alive, so I think we're okay.
大ヒットもしましたし。
And it was a great big hit too, this film.
でもやっぱり日本人はそういうヤクザとかああいうものがやっぱ好きですよね、ジャンルとして。で多分わからないですけど、海外の人はマフィア映画って好きなんじゃないですかね。それと同じ感じなのか、海賊と同じかも、パイレーツ・オブ・カリビアンと同じなんじゃないかなって。
So, well, Japanese people have a real love of this genre, of the Yakuza genre, and I think it translates to maybe the Western audience's love of mafia films, or maybe like Pirates of Caribbean. Maybe that's the equivalent.
Next question?
Hello again. This is my second time seeing this, and just as great the second time. And besides the Yakuza, this is very much a film about filmmaking. So I'm wondering if that would be something you would want to pursue in the future, making your own films.
でも私は映画っていうのは自分の役であったり、そういうキャラクターであったりってことが重要なんじゃなくて、いつもこう現場に行く時はその 映画作りに私が関わりたいかってことがものすごく重要で、で映画っていうのはやっぱり監督がまあ中心となって撮影部、照明部、録音部、俳優部で衣装部、メイク部っている、その私はやっぱ俳優部の一人として現場には携わっているつもりなので、私はもうすでに映画作りの現場にいると思うんです。だから映画にこう携わる際、私もものづくりの、まあ、職人としての気持ち、プロとしての気持ちがものすごく大事だと思うし、それは各チーム同じですし、同じ同等のラインですよね。皆さんそれぞれの部がじゃないといい映画は撮れないと思うし、名作も生まれないんじゃないかなと思うんで、だけど自分でディレクターをやってみたいかとかって聞かれると、ちょっとやっぱりディレクターをやってちょっと精神的にきつそうな人とかいっぱい見てるんで、私はちょっと俳優部として関われたらいいなと思ってます。
So for me, what's important in filmmaking is not so much the role or the character that I'm playing, but the question that I always ask myself is, when I step on set, do I want to be involved with this film, with this project as a whole? And of course, in filmmaking, the director plays a very central role, but that's not what constitutes a film. What constitutes a film is the makeup department, the lighting department, costume, sound, and so forth. So it's really important for me to have that awareness as part of a team, to have a professional awareness as a craftsman. And so all those different departments that are involved, we are on the equal playing field. We're at the very same equal level. And of course, with that said, if somebody asks me if I want to be a director, well, I've seen a lot of directors who hit the effects of that psychological taxing effect of filmmaking. So perhaps I should just be an actor for now.
Next question.
この映画にってことですか?
The question was, you look so young, but there were so many famous, distinctive actors involved in this project. What was the budget of the film?
すごくシビアな答えになってしまうんですけど、そんなにやっぱ高いバジェットで今日本は映画を制作することがとても難しくなってて、高ければ高いほど制約はどんどん増えていくし、高ければ高いほど本当に政治が動いてしまうのが現実なんです。でみんなに見てもらうというのでものすごくこうポップで分かりやすいものしか作らない、冒険をしない人がすごく増えてて、でその中でやっぱり最近は低予算などでいろんな面白い映画ができてきてるんですけど、今回その3はまあこういう新しいジャンルに挑戦するにあたってものすごくこうシビアなお金の問題あったと思うんですけど、セットはやっぱものすごくこうギリギリの値段で作っていましたし、それでもやっぱり役者さんの力で、まあ、役者さんとあとスタッフとあとまあ監督とっていう、まあ、その力で出来上がった映画だと思うので、まあ、金額はもちろん大事なんですけど、そのやっぱ皆さんの本気度がの方が大事っていうか、やっぱ金額じゃないけど、そういう面白い映画ができることによってどんどんまた日本映画がもっと活発化してくれたら嬉しいなって思うし、その3であったり、まあ、いろんな才能ある映画監督がもっともっといっぱいお金を集めていい映画ができるような環境になれば私はいいなと思ってます。
Of course, it was quite severe. Of course, this film was not made with a very high budget. And the reality in Japanese cinema filmmaking these days is that the higher the budget, the more restrictions that you face, the more political it gets. So, and also the producers get less adventurous as well. And it's very difficult to make something that's not apparent or pop or clear. So in that sense, but at the same time, there are a lot of low budget films that are very interesting. And director Sono, when taking on this very new genre with this film, we created the set with a very shoestring budget, but it was the power of the crew and the cast and also the director, that the culmination of our powers that enabled this film. So I think, you can talk about money, but at the same time, I think what really matters is the seriousness of the people that are involved. And I hope that films like this really inspire and invigorate Japanese cinema and create an environment in which directors like director Sono can thrive. Mm-hmm.
Well, this is all the time we have for this evening, but the craziness is going to continue, so let's play in Hell Party.